This conference will now be recorded.
Hey, hi team. Welcome to manual2selenium.com. This is Bashir. Today's agenda is going to be installations and setup of Protractor, and we'll be running one sample script. Prerequisite is you should know what is mean by Protractor and why we need it. Yeah, let's take a look at the prerequisite and what we are going to do as a part of this video. Okay, now see here, we will be using Visual Studio Code for writing our scripts as an IDE. We will be using this IDE. Okay, you have Eclipse, Sublime Text, WebStorm, many things are there, but I prefer Visual Studio Code, and most of the people use it. I will also show you one sample video in the future how to run the Protractor scripts using Eclipse. And what else you need? You need Java to run your programs, either for Selenium, the same thing you need it. So here also you need Java. And you need additionally two things. I mean, you need to install Node.js. What is mean by Node.js? Okay, so to explain you what is mean by Node.js, it's a runtime environment. It provides runtime environments to execute the JavaScript files. If I show you an example, say for example, I have written, just a minute. If I have any sample code like this, I will say console.log. Console.log, and here I will say welcome. This is a JavaScript code, right? Right, I have three times, and I will save it on the desktop. I will say demo node.js. Right, so if I execute this, it is not going to work out for us. Right, it will show you the error. But where you are going to execute, I mean in JavaScript, right? So you can execute over here. If I inspect over here in the browser, if you go to console, whatever the comments that I written, if I paste it over here and run it, yes, it will print it. Right, it's a console, you can write it. I mean, we know it in every browser, JavaScript engines will be there, and that will execute the same thing over here. But what happens if I need, if I want to execute JavaScript on the desktop applications, I want to develop any desktop applications related to JavaScript. So in that particular scenario, so how can you do that, right? If I ask you one question, can you execute Java program without Java install? No, right? The similar kind of thing. So Node.js will give you that platform where you can execute your JavaScript on desktop level. Okay, now for example, if I want to run this particular thing, I will simply say go to desktop. I will open up command prompt, cd, paste it over here. My bad. Right, if I say dir, you will be having many options. Let me clear that. If I say demo node dot js, it will say, I do not know about this command. But if you say node demo node, right? Yes, demo node dot js. Okay, what is the wrong thing over here? Okay, I will tell you the reason why it is not coming. Okay, the reason is I have installed my Node.js over here somewhere here. Okay, if I place my application over here, I mean my program over here, now I can execute it. Cd in that place and cls, and you can run your program now. See, welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, and what exactly this means, should I place all my JavaScript files where exactly the Node.js is available? No, it is not mandatory. Same like, right? So you have Java bin, right? Path. So do you place all your Java files over there? No, simply you will, you know, place wherever you want. The only thing is that you will specify the class path, I mean class path in the environment variables. Similarly, you can do the same thing with the Node.js also. Okay, that we will see when we are installing the Protractor. Okay, so I hope it is clear. So Node.js is nothing but a runtime environment where it will give you an option to run your JavaScript programs. And however, the Protractor, this is a basic thing, right? We have to automate AngularJS applications. We need this to be installed. And however, the framework, yes, we are going to use Jaspin framework as a part of this video tutorials. And which programming language are you using? I'm going to use TypeScript. And I will also show you what is mean by JavaScript. And TypeScript is nothing but a JavaScript only, okay? So whatever you write, it has to be converted to the JavaScript only. It has to be transpiled. I will tell you what exactly is that, okay? So ultimately, whatever you write in TypeScript, the same thing will be converted to the JavaScript only, okay? So TypeScript is not an independent one, okay? That's it, guys. I mean, these are all prerequisites that we require. And we are going to see how to install Visual Studio, Node.js, and how we can set up. And you may, come across with the different configuration files like conf.js, ts, json, tsconfig.json, package.json, those kind of things. You will be seeing it. And also, I will run a sample script and let's see how it goes on, okay? So let's, start installing the things, okay? The first one is Java. Okay, so I think most of the people know how to install the Java. Okay, so download it and install in your machine. If you need, I can say this is a thing, Java JDK download. This is the official site. You can download over here JDK. What is that JDK? So this is a JDK. Okay. So you can download from here. Same thing, you will be having this icon. Let me close all these things. You will be having this icon. Simply double click, same thing you can forward. Okay, so let me copy this URL so it might be helpful for you in future, right? So this is the first URL we have. And first thing that we install is, let me write it down over here what we are doing, JDK, or I would say Java install. First thing, we have installed the Java. And what you need second? I need second Node.js to be installed in my machine. Okay, so what exactly node we have seen, right? Okay, so let's see where exactly it is available. I will say Node.js download, and this is the official website. Okay. Simply double click on Windows installer. When you click on that, you can find out one icon like this. Okay, same thing, double click, next, 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 accept the license, the same thing, we know, right, how to install a software. Okay, let me copy paste here. This is the second URL. And what else you need? Third one, you need to download Microsoft Visual Studio, Microsoft Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code download. Okay, if you go over here, where is that Visual Studio? Here, this is the one. Okay, so simply you click on free download, it will be downloaded. It's a free, it's not a Visual Studio we are using, just Visual Studio Code, editor kind of thing. Okay, so this is the third URL we have. If needed, I will place these things in share drive or anywhere so that you can access it. So these things we have done, right? So Java we installed, Node.js we installed, and we installed this particular Visual Studio Code also. Okay, so what should be the step after this? Okay, so once you're done with all these things, first you confirm whether all the things are installed properly or not. Okay, so I will, for that, let me close this command and let me go to command prompt again. So here I will simply say node-v and enter. You can see after installing node.js, it will say the version. Okay, so the command is to verify Node.js installed in your version, you know, in your machine or not. So node hyphen v, you can, you know, completely say node hyphen version, you know, that will also good. No need to write everything. Node space hyphen v is enough. So once it is done, we have to open the 1 minute. We have to open the Visual Studio Code. Okay, so icon will be there. Just simply click it and you can open it. Right, so we have confirmed Node.js. Okay, so after that we have opened Visual Studio Code. Okay, so you know, first time you can see these things will be there. Okay, and basic things, because I have already installed, so these recent information is showing up, otherwise it will not show. Okay, you have many options. Before that, we have to create one folder over here. Okay, so let me create one folder. This video is going to be a little lengthy because you know, protractor setup and installation you know, always takes a lot of time, but only one time, right? We are not doing every time. Protractor demo. Okay, so this is a file where I will be placing you know, all my project related, that means nothing but you're, you know, setting up one project. Okay, I would say all my project should come over here, all the files whatever I write, it should come over here. Okay, now let's go to your here, and I will simply say, you can say open folder, or else you can also say here. Okay, so you can select it, or else you can say enter, click on select folder. Now it will select the folder for you. Okay, so it's just basic, we are not required. So this is a folder that you have. So once you, you know, create the folder, you have to you know, execute some of the commands. Okay, so once we open the Visual Studio Code, we created a folder, right? Create a folder. You can give any name. I have given which name, this one, right? So let me paste it over here, folder name is. So once it is done, I have open folder with Visual Studio Code, VS Code. Okay, now it is done. Once it is done, I have to start you know, installing the things. Like I have to install protractor, node modules, many things are there that we will see now. Okay, now first thing that you have to do is right click, you will get one command prompt over here. Okay, so whenever you select, right click and open command prompt, you can go there, or else from here also you can say command prompt somewhere. It is, it should be here, integrated terminal. Okay, so either way you can use it. Okay, so best way is just right click, open in command prompt, whatever you have, it will open in the, you know, console. Okay, both consoles are same. Okay, now here I have to start with a command. Okay, the first command we are going to write is, I would say npm init. This is the first command I'm going to write it, npm init. Simply say enter. Okay, so what is the command we have written now? Npm init, right? Okay, so once it is done, so we have to keep track of the commands that we are writing. So first command is npm init, first command, right? Okay, so here it will ask you you know, some of the details, like, okay, so package name, yes, you can give any name. So this is a demo package. Version, I don't need anything. This I will say, this is demo from manual to Selenium on protractor. Entry point, I do not have. Test command, nothing. Git repository, if you want to clone it from the Git repository, you can specify over here. Currently we are not using this. Keywords, nothing. Author, Bashir Muhammad. and license, nothing not required. Here you simply say yes, that's it. Okay, so whatever you're using, I mean, you just I would say in basic information you have to provide it. Okay, so as soon as you provide all this information, you can observe that something is got created over here. Okay, see here, nothing but whenever you do this one, so outcome is going to be a package.json file. Okay, package.json file. What is mean by package.json? It's a file which is in JSON format. What is mean by JSON? JavaScript annotation. One of the format where communication goes between the applications, right? Earlier we have XML format, right? So in addition to that, nowadays most of the web services and most of the things are communicating using this JSON format only. Okay, so most of the files in Protractor also you will find JSON. Okay, so here basic thing is done. Now I have to start installing the things which are required to run the Protractor. Okay, the second command is you will be having npm Protractor. Okay, so you have to use one command, npm Protractor, and say enter. It will install the Protractor. Did I say anything wrong? Okay, npm install Protractor. It will start installing the Protractor into that folder. Okay, so you have one more option, -g. Globally you can install it, but I would recommend you do everything locally. That means you are installing the Protractor to this particular specific project only. Okay, so it is getting installed. Second command, whatever you use, this one, right? This is the right. So outcome is going to be see here, it got done. Okay, let me clear it. You can find out after this particular one, you can see node modules got installed over here. There is one package, I mean there is one folder with the node modules come into the picture. You can see in that, you can find out where is that Protractor. See here, it got installed over here. Okay, and what else you required? Okay, so many things are there. We need Jasmine, we need some dependencies and all. Okay, now why we should go in this way? Okay, what exactly this package that JSON is? You developed one framework and you have installed all the jar files required to run the particular script. You want to give it to your friend, then what you do generally? So will you give all the jar files, copy pasting, and give it to the user? It's not possible, right? So if you see in real time, you will be using Maven, kind of thing. You will give palm.xml, right? What palm.xml will do? Whatever you updated there, you will give it to them, and he will, when he runs, it will be automatically, whatever you mention in the palm.xml, all the jar files mentioned over there will get installed on his machine. Similarly, here also, when you're developing, you can start, specifying all the information over here. But when it need to your teammate, you don't need to give all these files. Simply, if you give this particular package.json, and if you say npm install command, all the jar files which are available, all the dependencies which are required to execute that particular project will be installed over there. Okay, so he doesn't need to worry about whether he is using same as like you are not. Okay, same like palm.xml kind of thing. Okay, so to save some time, you can install many things. Okay, so I have one sample one. So this is a package.json. If I show you in the format, or else if I copy paste in my machine, control A, control paste. Okay, see the same thing. I mean, you know, I said I need, you know, Jasmine framework, I need these dependencies, I have to install protractor also, right? So I need everything is common except the before file is before file, and this file is differentiating only over here, right? So we know, right, every time whenever you install whenever you this command, it will be installing into your that particular things will be installed in your folder, but you have to use hyphen hyphen save also. Okay, so like this, if I show you where is that, not this one, yeah, same thing. If I want to start with the npm init, you can do that. If you want to install TypeScript, you can say hyphen hyphen save. So you have to use this hyphen hyphen save. What will happen with this is whatever it gets installed, it will automatically update this package.json. So next time when you want to give it to your friend, you don't need to give this node modules, because node modules are nothing but a, you know, collection of JavaScript libraries. Many things will be there, so you don't need to give it all those things. Simply give your scripts, give your framework, and give this package.json. It doesn't need to do all those things. But whenever you are doing it first time, whenever this package.json is not available, you have to execute these series of actions. npm install. If you want to install protractor, you can do it. Only thing is that this will only install, but if you want to update the package.json, you have to use hyphen hyphen save. Okay, similar way, if you want to download, if you want to install the protractor, I mean TypeScript, you can use this command. Okay, so these four series of actions you have to perform after this. Okay, so here once you say, right, so these are the line by line installation that you have to do it. I would recommend you, I will give you this particular package.json. Simply once you created your folder, paste it over there and run only one command, that is nothing but a npm install. That's meant automatically all the dependencies that I'm using that will be coming into in your machine in the specified folder. Okay, so I hope it is clear what is mean by package.json, what is the use of it. Okay, simply palm.xml I would say, but it's not build tool, it's just where you can download the things. Okay, so one more word we are using, but if you observe npm, what is mean by npm? Node package manager. You have repository kind of thing, right? Whenever you use Maven, so it will go there, it will take it from here. The same thing, whenever this package.json, when you say npm install, it will be installing from the npm node package manager, a repository kind of thing. Okay, you can also search in the Google saying that Google npm npgms, see, node package manager. Okay, everything you will find, everything over here, all the JavaScript libraries you can search over here. Okay, I hope it is clear. Okay, so what I will do, I will remove all my existing things over here. Okay, and I will show you the demo how exactly we are going to. Generally, if you follow this, you have to do all these things. Okay, but so many complex things will come if you are doing in this way. Okay, so I would recommend, I will give you this package.json, simply perform only one action, that is that cls npm install and say enter. Whatever you specify over here, all the things are going to download it automatically. Okay, see, the same thing, whatever you specified, it will be downloading under the node underscore modules folder. Okay, so let it get installed. And meanwhile, I will, I will demonstrate couple of the options we are over here. Additionally, before, file that I created initially now is having three lines of difference. This one, okay, what exactly it does. As I said earlier, even though you're writing the scripts in the TypeScript, that should be converted to the JavaScript. That means you have to transpile it. Okay, so the command is you have TSC. Okay, so transpiling. Okay, so whenever you run this, automatically all the JavaScript files which are available in this folder, .ts extension of TypeScript is going to be .ts for JavaScript and .js. And all the whenever you run this, all the .ts file are going to be converted to the .js files. Okay, and what is mean by this line? Now, as I said earlier, you have to specify one place whenever you combine all these things, right? Whenever transpiling all these things into JavaScript files, you have to specify more location, right? So that is a location I'm specifying over here. And conf.js, have the doubt in the mind, and I will explain you in future. Okay, in this video only. Okay, so it got installed, and you can see the same thing. You can find out the protractor, you can find out the Jasmine's over here, framework over here, and everything whatever you specified over here, all the things might have installed. Now, once it is done, what should be my next step? Okay, your next step is you have to create one TS config file. Okay, so here you can find it out, TS config file. Okay, so this is also one of the file that is needed when you are executing through TypeScript. Okay, so how it will be generated? If you come over here, if you say TSC hyphen or else init is enough. I will tell you why it is not showing. Okay, the thing is that everything is available, the TypeScript is available over here, but we are in the folder location of this one, but the this particular where we are TypeScript, right? Okay, lemon obqrst, this one here, TypeScript is available over here. Right, so it is available over here. So it is showing some errors. Let me check what could be the issue. Is it installed every time? Test package 1.0. See over here, protractor. Okay, so here you can find ts.config file, but I don't want to over here, I want to place it here. I want to place it over here. Okay, so one thing you can copy paste from from there to here, or else you can type this command tsc hyphen init. Why it is not recognizing it, I will tell you. If you go to this particular my computer properties and system settings, we have to set the environment variable, otherwise it is not going to show you. Okay, if you go to the path, okay, and the last time I have installed for this path, okay, let me remove that earlier path. Or else you can copy paste new path also. There will not be much issue with that. Okay, so let me copy paste this path. Node modules dot bin is enough. Okay, because why we are going dot bin is every option that you are running, Jasmine or WebDriver manager or TSC, everything is available under dot bin folder. So we have to, the system should refer to this particular place, right? Okay, so that is a reason why I am copy pasting over here. Okay, so So is it pasted? Protractor demo. Yes, it got pasted. Simply say OK and OK. And this is not going to recognize now. For that, you need to exit and come back. Definitely, it is going to be a little lengthy. You should have patience. Okay, now I can use the command. What is that command we have? TSC-init. Right, now it is not show you. It will not throw you any error. Okay, it will create the TSC config file for you. Okay. What is wrong with it? Shall I use -? Yes. So my bad. So you have to use this command. Okay. The command you have to use is this one. Okay. There you can see tsconfig.json file. Okay. This will have many options. This will be confusing if you have. Okay. What I will do? I will give you my tsconfig file to you. Simply, what you will do? Control A, Control C, and paste it over here. Delete everything. Paste it. And I will explain you what exactly these are and all. That means, as I said earlier, in package.json, we are, transpiling JavaScript, TypeScript to JavaScript, right? What happens if it is applicable for the entire folder? Because there are, hundreds and hundreds of JavaScript files are available over here, TypeScript files are available over here. All the files are going to be converted with no reason. We want only our scripts, basic script that we written in the TypeScript, those only should be converted to the TypeScript. So in that particular scenario, I'm telling that, hey boss, don't consider every file. Please exclude this package, this entire folder, ignore it. Apart from this folder, you can consider everything inside this particular protractor demo folder. Okay. Here, the same thing I'm telling that, you can find out your converted Java files over here. Please go there and create one directory, place it over here. Okay. So target, I'm going to convert to ES5. You can find out ES6 kind of, we have versions, right? Here I'm specifying ES5. Okay. So we are done with the package.json. We are done with the tsconfig. Now what I will do is I will create one sample script now. Okay, so before that I need one important entry point for any I would say TS. See here, you can find out this TS icon over here. Go there, you can write, you need to write some piece of code before you start with the coding over here. Okay, so first let me write my sample script. Okay, for that I'm gonna create one new folder over here. I will say test specs. In that test specs, I will start writing my scripts like demo spec dot ts. That means extension is going to be ts, TypeScript. Okay, so here you can write, it's just a demo only, nothing to worry about, nothing to scare. You should be focusing only on installing, and I will be giving all these files to you. Okay, so I will be giving all these files to you. These are all very important files, package.json, tsconfig. These two are important for you. Okay, I will be providing just tests on it. Okay, we will be concentrating more in detail what exactly each and every option in config.ts is, we are going to do it. Okay, and each and every step, what exactly it means. Okay, so timing, you just need to, observe the things. Okay, so describe. This is these two commands, whatever I am writing here right now, is just related to Jasmine framework, like a test ng. Okay, so describe, in every spec file you can have n number of describe blocks. One describe block can have it blocks, and inner describe, like one describe can also have describes in it. We will discuss each and every topic one by one, but our focus is just to make sure that the script, the installation, whatever we have done, is currently going smoothly or not. Okay, so here I will use one statement, import I will say browser from in protractor. That's it. Okay, so now you can start using commands. Whatever you are using, you know, driver.get command, and you can, you know, you can now get to any specific URL. I want to now get to this URL now. This URL, not this one, this URL. Okay, now I want to get the title of it. Here I can write console.log, and I will simply say script started. And here I will say script ended. Okay, and I want to print simply, I would say, what is this called, title. Okay, so how will you do that? So browser dot get title. Okay, so here if you see, you know, in JavaScript and you know, TypeScript or AngularJS based applications, you will be hearing couple of words. One, concept of asynchronize and synchronize. Two, the concept of promises and callbacks. Okay, and async, this, you know, terminologies you will be using. Okay, so every command which is present in this particular you know, maximum of commands that is available in Protractor are you know, JavaScript callbacks. Okay, I mean JavaScript promises only. Okay, that means it will not, generally what we will do in Selenium, driver dot you know, get title, you will assign one driver dot find element dot something get text, you will assign to a variable and do it. So each and every line of code will be executed. Second line is not going to be executed unless the first line will get completed, but here in JavaScript that will not be the concept. Okay, so based upon some callbacks and you know, things, you know, the whatever lines which are in the queue may not be executed properly. Okay, that we will see in the future, what is mean by callback, what is mean by promise, what is mean by asynchronous concept. Okay, so here I'm simply writing the things just to print the title of the URL on the page. Okay, so function here I will say data. So console.log URL of pages plus data. Okay, that's it. I mean, this will print on the console. I will show you what exactly this means, what is mean by then, why we are writing like this. Okay, so I think we are done with everything. Yeah, we need const.js file. Okay, I will tell you what does that mean. I have const.js file already in my machine. So what I will do, copy everything and paste it over here. Okay, now if I explain you this, I'm telling that I'm going to use browser Chrome, and this is my Selenium address. What is this means? In order to run your test script, you should have your Selenium standalone server up and running, otherwise it will not run. You might have seen this in Selenium, what is that called, before WebDriver, what you have, Selenium IDE, Selenium RC. Yeah, same, I mean, here also the same thing, you should have you know, this particular server up and running. You also have one more option, direct connect. If you pass that particular, if you specify that particular property over here, direct connect colon true, it will directly connect without this particular server and up and running. But I hear that some of the Firefox versions and some of the versions of types, I mean Node.js, it is not working properly. Okay, so better to use this one. Okay, nothing wrong in that, or else you can use direct connect and option. Okay, that I will show you in the future. And what else you have, I'm telling that on prepare, make sure that you have browser window maximized. Okay, and framework we are going to use is Jasmine, and I said you know, you can find out the test scripts in this folder. That means test scripts sample demo.js, we have to change this one, right? So this is going to be demo spec.js, and don't forget you know, don't confuse between the TS and JS. As I said earlier, you will be writing only the scripts in the TypeScript. Execution and everything goes only on the JavaScript. TypeScript is just to write, you know, your code. Why you should write in TypeScript when you have JavaScript? See, in JavaScript, you don't have the concept of classes, interfaces, and all. Okay, so we are almost, you know, everybody, most of the programmers are habituated to, you know, Java. I mean, I would say classes, objects, kind of thing. In order to make the, you know, developer's life easily, the concept of TypeScript is came. I will show you an example also. Okay, now we are done with the config.ts file. We are done with this one. Okay, now only thing is that we have to run it. Okay, so I will simply say, let me check all the files. This will be converted, no issues here. And package.json, here it will be there. Conf.js, okay, no issues. Okay, now time to run it. Okay, so I will say npm-test and say enter. It will not run, right? I will tell you the reason because let it complete it first. I will show you what exactly is that. What is the message it is saying? It is saying come down using the Selenium server over here. There is no web driver, you know, available over there. The reason is whatever we have done, we are simply, you know, if you go to package.json, we installed only protractor, but that is not going to be enough. Okay, so you need some commands to run in order to work with the protractor. Okay, looks very I would say lengthy, confusing, but this is way one time activity you have to do it. Okay, so you have to perform few commands. Webdriver-manager-update. Okay, that means you need to update all your, it will be downloading all the Gecko driver and Chrome driver executable files, standalone servers, and everything. It will be downloaded from the NPM. Okay, so it is getting downloaded. So what is the command we have used? Webdriver-manager-update. Once it is done, you have to use the same command. Only thing is that instead of update, you have to use start. So this will start the Selenium standalone server. Okay, so let's see whether it is completed or not. Yes, it is done. You can see Gecko driver and, you know, maximum of the server that you have, Selenium standalone server 3.13. okay, so the command that I said, start, this will start the Selenium standalone server. You can see Selenium standalone server is up and running. Okay, so this will be running. You should not close it and don't touch it. Okay, so I want one more terminal. You can click over here, or else you can click over here. Okay, so I am using over here this one, plus symbol, new terminal. Okay, that means if you want to switch, you can switch it. Okay, so here I have to use npm-test. Let's see, do we get any challenges or what exactly it goes on. It's not that easy, and you can observe here left side, it is creating converted JS files, right? Yes, it has launched. It should now get to the specific URL. Yes, it is now getting to the URL, and it should print out the title of the page. And let's see. You can say one spec is found, zero failures, and nothing is there. And if you see, if you go to this particular one, I have written three statements. One is script started, script ended, and this is how the sequence should be there, right? Starting, URL of the page, and ended, and see what happened. Started, script ended, then after that this is came. Something strange. This is the reason why, you know, most of the people confused over here. Okay, I will tell you what exactly this means, why it is came like this. Okay, but time being, just it is a you know URL, it got printed on the console. Okay, so this is how you can set up your protractor using Visual Studio Code. Okay, so what I will do, I will provide all these. You don't require many things. One is, as I said earlier, you want one project folder to be created and you want the things to be installed properly, like Java, Node.js, Visual Studio Code. Create the folder, and I will be giving you this tsconfig file and conf.ts file and package.json file. That means you don't need to install on your own, you need to only one command, that is npm install. Okay, and you can place ISTs and you can start running it. Okay, so I will place maybe in Google Drive and I will share it in the YouTube. Yeah, I will provide that. Okay, so that's it guys. Little lengthy, but okay. So yeah, if you like and subscribe, you know, share my channel link. Okay, so like and subscribe to my channel. Okay, so thank you from manual to selenium.com. Thank you, have a good day ahead.